the Kiss poster, the $1,000 original movie 6 foot by 4 foot Kiss poster.
Mm-hmm.
I have the wall space for it.
Yes.
We're buying it.
And I discussed it.
Was it your housemate?
Yes.
Uh-huh.
And there was a resounding no.
What? To tell your housemate that some things are not necessarily, like, maybe their opinion is valued, but it's not, maybe they don't have a vote.
There was a, it was a non-negotiable no.
Oh, man.
I'm heartbroken.
That one?
Yep. I'm heartbroken. No. That's art. It's a piece of art for the wall.
It would look so good because, especially because
it's huge, and I have the wall space.
And all four members are there, but the big picture is of Gene. And Gene's the demon. He's the coolest one.
She's like, I don't want to look at that fucking Batman all day.
That's not what, he's a demon.
I know, I made the correction.
Thank God.
I was trying to sell it. I'm like, look at that. I mean, all four members, the demon.
You said that?
Yeah, I did. I'm like, they're all on it. I was, yeah.
They're
it's in French. I think I even said it in French. Oh yeah.
That's great. It's
yeah.
in French, like it's fine art.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Troy, what do you think? Maybe I'm wrong. I trust
you. I think
your
you
judgment.
Should just do it.
I think you should just do it.
It's your place,
yeah,
man.
It's your place.
Yeah.
You got to be happy.
Yep.
No, but I mean, what do you think of the poster?
I think it's awesome.
You do?
Yeah. It's two of Gene's, so two is always better than one.
All when right, it comes to Gene Simmons.
That's right.
It's a really awesome poster.
Yeah, it's really cool.
Yeah, it is. And you can see all their faces. Look how good Paul Stanley looks.
He does
he
look
looks
great.
Tough.
That yeah, he, that looks like the close to the Dynasty face. What do you think, Mike? Intern Mike, let me get your opinion.
And also, I think Ace is on drugs in that picture.
Yes, I imagine.
I think if you look at his eyes, it looks like Ace is probably on
drugs. Well, you can always
drugs.
Tell if it's a photo from the 70s. He's on drugs.
Yeah, yeah.
I actually like Kiss. I think you should get it.
He's right. Yeah.
I think it would be cooler if the Ankh was in it, but, you know.
Yeah.
You're an Ankh guy, though. You've always been an Ankh guy.
But that would look so good, like, on that wall.
Yeah. I was talking to somebody this weekend who, like, Kiss. I'm trying to remember who it was, but they would agree. You know who would think that that's a good idea? Bubba Ray Dudley.
He's in good shape, right?
He would think it's a really good idea.
Are there a lot of them around?
Maybe
no.
Add that to your argument. Like Bubba Ray.
Bubba Ray Dudley would get, I don't know how Devon.
No, she wouldn't know who he is. I barely know who he is, and I've interviewed him.
He put Mae Young through a table, if it makes any difference. Yeah, there can't be a lot of them around. That's a $1,000 piece, $1,100. Well, that's a very rare item.
Yeah.
Plus, it's an advertising item, right? Like, nobody ever...
It's a movie... It's probably from a movie theater. That's why it's folded.
Movie theater.
I'm like, assuming, yeah.
Yeah, people didn't get to buy those and put them in their houses. It's probably like a movie theater employee from the 70s. Was able to take it and somehow put it in, and keep it in great shape. Maybe they keep it kept in a very valuable, precious
a lot
spot.
Of, I've never spent that much for a
you got
picture.
It. You got it, though. It's a poster. It's a work of art.
It's vintage.
It's a work of art.
It is. I mean, it is a 40-year-old
Some things
thing.
Are just worth that much money.
I spent $400 on a Richard Pryor movie poster from Live in Concert from 79. That looks great.
Right,
it's folded just like that.
If I remember correctly, I spent significantly more than that on Mick Foley's worn WrestleMania 2000 shirt.
Well, I know.
And you can get those folds out.
If you wanted to.
They frame out and they look nice.
Yeah when you frame it out, they like steam it or
something. I don't mind.
No, you don't want to do that. You'll ruin the poster.
Yeah, I don't mind the folds because I know that it's not a defect. It's literally just how the movie theater would display them.
That's how they used to be shipped. Yeah.
But that's how they were shipped, so
but
I don't mind
you
that.
Can, once you flatten it in the frame, like,
yeah, I've done
the
it
marks
before.
Will be there, but it'll still look good.
You can see it. Again, the Richard Pryor one is big. It's not that big, but it's a few feet. It's because it's from, it's almost like one of those things that would sit in the movie theater. But they were all folded back then, so.
Your significant other knows the position that they put themselves in. Okay, they know who you are.
Yeah.
You're the type of person who, if you've got a 4 foot by 6 foot space of wall, it should have a giant Kiss poster there. I don't understand what the issue is. And it's French.
It's culture.
I know.
That's, well, that's
it's culture.
The, that's where you're
it's
meeting them halfway.
Culture.
It's cultured. Who doesn't like France?
I got...
It's one of the great romance languages.
That's a cool poster.
It's so awesome. Cool.
It's... Among the coolest posters I've ever seen.
All right, I don't believe anybody. If you think that I don't know you three blithering idiots, of course I don't believe a word.
I genuinely think it's a cool poster.
Gene's
the
fine.
Thing I like about it is, as a Kiss fan, it's a rare thing.
It's a rare item. No, it would be cool to see that.
What about letting her hang, like, two things?
I said to her, all right, what would I have to do? Mm-hmm. Let's deal. What do I have to do to get the poster?
This is what, now we're talking. Now we're talking.
And she mentioned a couple of things. Mm-hmm. I have to admit they're pricey. But I felt like I was cheating in a way because one of them I was already going to do anyway. And I said, yeah, I'm already going to do that anyway. Like,
why'd you say that?
Because I don't want, because this poster's too big. She knew we were already going to do that. The poster's too big to take down. And then I was like, I was going to do that anyway. And she goes, yeah, and I don't like that. That fucking poster. I don't want to look at that all day. I'm in the kitchen. I'll be looking right at it. That fucking Batman.
It's a great spot.
It's the demon.
I know exactly where you're talking.
You mean
about.
Where the Woody Allen poster is? Another hero, by
perfect
the way.
Spot.
It's the demon.
Oh, you're talking about the alligator? No.
Right. I think we just on two love. Yeah.
That's why I'm a fan.
Yeah. No. I think that's a demon. First of all, not a Batman.
I know.
Okay. She's wrong about that.
Yes. Yes. Maybe she said with derision.
Yeah. That's not. Yeah, there's no reason for her to denigrate
fucking bat.
She shouldn't. That's the God of Thunder she's talking about.
Trust me, I dug in. I was like, look at the, you know, I mean, it's so big. It's in French. I'm like, the four guys are there.
Did you tell her what they call him?
Dr. Love? No. I did not.
Oh, you should have.
What does it say at the bottom of the poster? Can I see
it's all the credits?
Oh, okay. It looks like a movie thing, though, right?
Yeah. It is.
Yeah. It's like movie.
From a theater?
Movie credit. It's definitely from a movie theater.
It was probably hung in the theater.
Yeah.
It's probably the same French movie theater that they burned Hitler alive in.
Oh, possibly.
Remember when they did that?
It looks like it's in really good shape for a poster of that.
Ilk.
Yeah. No, it looks really good shape. Because that's an original. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I have like a big.
I see it there.
I don't have it hung up anywhere. I
see it.
But I have a big vinyl. Like 6 foot, 7 foot, something, vinyl Subway poster thing for Kill Bill Volume 1. Like just the yellow with the sword and the logo. I bought it on eBay like when the movie came out.
Are you
going
to hang it or just
I have no idea where I would put it.
How
right
big
now.
Is it?
It's at least as big as that, if not bigger.
Is there room
it's
in your
like a Subway ad, right?
Yeah.
I have a bus ad on my wall. I have a Kiss, of course. It's from 1977. From the side of the of a bus in 77, they had the Kiss Alive 2 tour, and one of them was December 16th. My father took me to one of those shows when I was a kid.
What if you took that down?
No, there's no
you
room.
Wouldn't do it.
No, I can't. It's long and thin.
No, but what if you took it down just as a symbol, like just a show? Like, okay.
No, it looks too cool. I can't. All right. It's great.
All right, you're not willing to budget.
No, that's
okay.
It right there.
It's cool.
On the side of a bus. Yeah,
it's
huge.
It's really cool. It's like the album art on each side and then a picture of the concert.
Yeah, and it's got the Madison Square Garden dates.
Well, what if you told her that she could paint your office hot pink?
I was already willing to do that.
Well, come on,
you
gotta
stop saying you
stop
were already
doing
willing.
That.
No, but I mean, like, I'm gonna have to give up a lot. A lot.
You're learning how to share your life.
I'm already
you
hearing.
You have to share your life.
Yeah, I'm already hearing about. Like, she's like, yeah, no, the hallway looks cool. Those pictures are cool pictures. But then I hung up the Magic Johnson and Kareem, you know, as I should have back in the office. And she's like, they're nice pictures, but I just feel like it's all you.
It is.
And I'm like, I know. I can't even argue.
Bro, you're out.
I know.
Give it a year. Jim's going to be a man cave guy. Got to escape to the man cave where I can keep all my stuff. The man cave.
Yeah.
It's going to be Nathan for you when they're in while the women are shopping. And we're talking about sex, watching old sports, and drinking beers. Yeah. Yeah, that's. I mean. Well, now's the time to do it, right? Because you have to set the precedent now. If you keep running around saying I was going to do that anyway, you're going to get walked all over, which maybe you're into. I don't know.
I'm going to have to deal to get this done.
You're going to have to deal, right? Yeah. Which means now we have to commoditize everything. So you got to figure out, okay, what do you want in terms of decoration and wall space? Maybe if you give up some of your roach candles and let her put... Whatever.
No, we have the same taste in candles. Okay. I had bought a bunch when I was away of lesser candles, mm-hmm. and we're burning through them just to be done with them. We agree on the smells. The scents we're completely in tune with.
That's great.
Yeah.
That's how you know she's the one, they say.
Yeah.
What?
The bedroom has to be redone. Like, I need a new bed. I need a lot of stuff in the bedroom.
Because of the piss stains?
No, it's they're actually, I think, add softness and comfort to the bed, but they're going to be literally just, the bed is 20 years old. I've had it for 20 years. It was an O&A sponsor when we were on WNEW.
Wow.
So that went to my first apartment in the city. Like, that's how long I've had that.
What if you let her pick the duvet? You can pick any duvet you want.
This is going to be a vanity. She wants a giant mirror on the bedroom wall, like a giant mirror. So maybe
that sounds like a great compromise.
You get your mirror.
Yeah.
But you don't need to look in the mirror. You don't want to look
in the bedroom anyway.
Not as well, but it's just the idea. A mirror in the bedroom on the one wall would probably look cool because I understand there's no art being hung up there. I always had a dream of the Kiss Chopper posters being hung in my bedroom.
Your motorcycle
the four yeah. black background chopper posters, the motorcycle posters, was the ones that were always going to be hung in my bedroom.
Yeah.
On that one wall with Gene, Paul, Ace, and Peter on their mics.
That's no longer an option.
I wouldn't even think of it. I'm not even allowing myself to wonder.
It's not a topic worth broaching.
No. It's just not. What's that?
The dream is dead.
That's dead. I have mentioned
that. The dream is over. Hey now.
Yeah, I got a... That was also a very definitive no.
Oof.
Yeah.
Have you considered redoing the hallway?
No, it's too big. No, I mean, I'll swap out... there's plenty of
room.
No,
but I mean giving her maybe some hallway.
No, the hallway space. You can't.
But if you swap out, you can't just swap out now to be like, fair is fair, I'll swap out. It should be a trade. I will swap out some of this stuff if I can put my 6-foot Kiss poster up.
That poster is going to cost me the office and the entire bedroom. The entire bedroom, it's going to cost me.
I don't think that's a bad trade.
No, I have the hallway and the living room.
Here's the problem.
I know.
It's a lot, though, but...
You're going to have to build a studio next to the Kiss poster, because otherwise you're going to do shit from home, and you're going to be in your office, and it's going to be hot pink, and if I know your lady like I think I do, it's going to be hot pink, maybe some feather boas, maybe some animal print.
Tacky.
It's going to be tacky.
Tacky girl
delightfully
shit.
Tacky.
Yeah.
Is it a Hooters?
Yeah, exactly. It's going to look like...
The animal print has already been discussed.
Okay. That's
on the sofa. I'm not getting a new sofa.
Like, it's going to be the perfect spot to do an after show for RuPaul's Drag Race.
Yeah.
But maybe UFC...
Yep.
Unleaded or whatever.
Unfiltered.
Unfiltered.
Unleaded. UFC unleaded.
UFC unleaded. UFC unfiltered. Coming from the RuPaul Drag Race after show studios.
Yeah.
Like, you think they might film extra scenes for the new Barbie movie in Jim's apartment?
1,000%. Like, Ryan Gosling dressed up as Ken would be perfect in the office. The only thing that it makes me sad about is that we're not still in the pandemic, because I would have loved for you to have to broadcast this show
from
home in that
office.
Well,
you wouldn't have seen it because I have the green screen.
Oh, the green screen.
Green screen saves you.
I hope she removes the green screen just for spite.
No, the green screen is a moneymaker, meaning it's for work. I have to use it for work.
Right. Otherwise, Doug Bell would lose his integrity.
Yeah.
Well, look, if you're giving up... Would you give up the office and the bedroom for the 6-foot Kiss meets the Phantom of the Park French poster?
Yeah, within reason. We'd have to agree on the bedroom, but the reality is she wants a headboard. I don't. I'll get a headboard. She wants a giant mirror and a vanity.
Oh, come on. These are costly items.
Yeah, I mean, I needed to re-up the furniture I've had for many, many years, and that bed has to go.
With that, all right, but this is what you gotta go home and say, this is the deal. I get this Kiss poster, and you will have more voting shares. You could have executive voting shares for the bedroom in the office.
But that poster, if it ever comes down, there's nowhere to store it. Like, anything else I can store in the closet, you can put stuff 6 feet by closet. 4 feet. There's no room for a 6-foot mammoth poster in the closet.
That's the best part. That means once you get the deal made and you can get it up on the wall, it never comes down.
I didn't go anywhere.
It wouldn't fit in your mementos closet?
No. I mean, it would, but it would block everything. Like,
right,
you know,
you couldn't
saying?
Get any more mementos is the problem.
Yeah, and the mementos would be taken over.
But that's good news, because that means she can't change her mind later. Yeah. You're like, well, there's no place to put it.
But do I like it enough to look at it forever?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes, is the answer.
I think that would look so good.
It would look fucking great.
Be so fun.
Maybe giving up the office and the bedroom. Think about it. Nobody that comes over to your house sees the bedroom. Who gives a fuck?
It's true.
The office, it's almost like a goof, right? It's kind of funny that you have to broadcast out of an animal print office. That's fun. It's fun.
And you get a piece of art in return.
Yeah, you do. And maybe one day Ace will come over to your house and sign it.
That'd be cool.
Yeah, that'd be super cool.
That'll bring you.
That's the thing. Every morning you'll wake up and you'll be happy.
I'll be honest.
Which is not the case right now.
I'll be honest. I have seen it before, and it did bring me happiness.
That's what I think. Like, finally, something that will give you enough joy that it will overcome your rage at Uber drivers in the morning.
Jason in Texas has a fair question.
Okay, what's going on, Jason? How are you?
Living the dream. What's going on with you guys?
Hi, Jason.
Well, we're trying to figure some stuff out for Jim right now.
Yeah. No. You're not trying to figure anything out. I don't know what the fuck is going on here right now, but I got a fucking cuck Jim.
We've always had a cuck Jim.
Can't put his own fucking shit in his own fucking house. Give me a fucking break. You're the fucking moneymaker in the fucking family. It's your house. It's your fucking show. Run it the right way. You're being told what you can and can't do by fucking Quasimodo Sam, who's got a fucking basement. That's all he's allowed to have in his own fucking house.
Great point.
Come on. What the fuck is going on here?
Jason,
I'm starting to lose faith.
I'm the moneymaker. I fucking pay. Do you think that hasn't flown out of my mouth already?
Yeah, here's the problem. That flies out of Jim's mouth, and then Jim's mouth gets closed with
something else.
That's
right. And I'm like, oh yeah, that's right. There's a trade here.
No, you're fucking killing me with the shade falling down. You got Sam who lives in fucking Bestchester, stuck in a basement making fun of your fucking windows. Jim, it's time you start smacking the shit out of some fucking people.
That's right. God damn it, Jason. Thank you very much. Thank you for the call. You're not wrong.
Yeah, that's
Say
right.
Say something about my shade again, Sam.
Boys. Yeah,
I love you, boys.
It's funny that your shade broke, Jim.
You boys are the fucking best.
Thank you. Well, Mick Foley's shirt has got sweat all over it. God damn it, I feel revitalized. No, it's weird, and it's funny what Jason said, because what Jason just said is literally my inner monologue.
Well, it's what you
pay for the fucking play.
It's what you would have said at one point if somebody else was saying
it. Would have, but I also, and I know that I technically could do it. Like, I know that.
But it's not healthy. Relationship is built on compromise.
It's not how I want to do it. Like, because I'm 54, and this is where I've come to in my life, where it's a good place, but I've done whatever the fuck I wanted in my apartment. I can hang anything I want. And it's like when you have to share your space with someone, you're like, you have to at least compromise. I don't want to be a dick. I just don't want to be a dick. I want it to be fair.
Yeah.
Like, because otherwise, we're living there. It's like...
Well, yeah. I mean, you don't want somebody to be there captive. You know?
Andy in Brooklyn has a comment.
What's up? What's up, Andy?
Hello.
Hello. Hello, sir.
Hello.
Hello.
I just want to say, Jim, you should get the poster, because if you're living with a woman in a year or two, you're going to have to give all that other rooms up anyway.
Yeah, no, that's... You know what? That's not a bad point. I'm going to lose some of those battles. Thank you, buddy. I am going to lose. And the reason that the office was not painted pink was because of the color of the shades. Mm-hmm. It actually was like... She actually went, I didn't realize the shades were going to be that color. Let's keep it white. Like, maybe... You know,
yeah, I mean,
but I was willing to do that.
Yeah, it's not like you've got to just make a couple compromises now and then you'll be done. It's like it's going to continue.
And the couch, she wants to get rid of the couch, and we wanted to get better.
I love that couch.
I do, but not for company. I'm actually ready to move on too, because it's like sitting in a fucking, it's like sitting in a scrotum. It's
right.
Just you sink into it,
and that's comfortable for you, but a lot of other people.
Of course,
like,
you're not supposed to sit face first on a sofa. But no, I wanted to. I wanted to get one that's a little bit firmer, a little better to sit on for people. I want to do that anyway, and she was adamant about that. But now that the couch is back, she's like, "Let's keep it for 6 months. It's comfortable." So she gives in all the time.
But even if you agree with the change or whatever, if it's her idea, you have to cash in your points.
Yeah.
Like, even if you agree, you have to go in your head. That's your inner monologue. I agree, but let me not agree fully. So it's like I have to make it clear that I'm making a compromise here, so that way I can cash in my chips later. and get this Kiss poster.
Yeah, I do like it. I really do like it. It's a weird,
it's a nice piece.
Unique.
It is. I mean, without, you know, blowing smoke or being goofy, it is. It is actually a nice piece. That if I saw that, and I think Travis is actually being sincere. If you saw that in Jim's place, it's like, no, that's, as a collector,
it's awesome.
That's a cool thing.
Yeah, that's a cool thing to have.
It'd be like if I had like an original WrestleMania poster that was like in the city advertising the event.
Yeah. And I do realize that if I got that and hung it, all of you would allow your true feelings about the poster to be known, and I would hear, it's awful.
Look at Gene, what a dick.
Yeah, what an asshole.
But I personally do like it very much.
I like it.
Yeah. Plus, it's almost life-size for Gene. It's 6 feet tall. It's a big
Gene.
Come
on, I would just talk to him.
You would?
Hey, Gene, you want to have some of my banana? Yeah. We can share it.
Yeah. All right. Oh, I couldn't hear you, Mike. A mic for the intern, Mike.
Now it's fucking shit. But no, really, truthfully, you should just get it. You should just, if it makes you happy, and it's cool. It actually, it is cool. Like,
see?
You just, I don't understand why we're thinking about this.
If I do, if it makes me happy, I should get it.
Yeah,
that's true. I should be paying for blowjobs again. They made me happy. They made me very happy.
I mean, look, good things are happening. I got a message. We did apparently get Greg Stone at least very close. Last time I talked to him, he was within like an arm's length of getting his 10,000 Instagram followers.
Oh,
like
right.
He might be there now. I'm talking like he was within 12 people.
Right.
And he was like hundreds away. So he's getting to keep his Galactus. If Greg Stone gets to keep Galactus, and he's got a young baby.
Yep, he's at over 10,000.
Yeah, we got him to 10,000, okay? I'm going to take credit on it. I'm going to do it. There's no data to back it up, but I don't see how else it happened.
I 100% agree.
He's getting to keep his Galactus. You should be able to keep that Kiss poster. Buy it.
Dude, I went in there and I measured along that wall. It's the perfect.
Oh,
it's perfect.
Oh, come on.
It's a sign. It's a sign.
It is a sign. That's happened to me before, and I'm like, well,
you got to.
The perfect space.
You got to. God wouldn't do this if he didn't intend for this to happen.
Sure he would. I have to move Woody over one. That's doable. It's a movie poster as well. They're both movie posters. I took down Raging Bull.
It's thematic. Why'd you take down Raging Bull?
The frame was falling apart. It was signed by LaMotta, which is actually cool.
But you tell her I took down Raging Bull.
I did that for you.
You said that to her?
Yeah, she went, what? What's Raging Bull?
Oh. See, I put up with you, even though you don't know what Raging Bull is. Yeah. I got to put up Kiss Meets Phantom of the Park. Maybe if you play the movie for her, she'll be into it.
Yeah, I mean, why not? It's a fan favorite.
It's a great movie.
Would you give up the space where that Ozzy picture is?
What do you mean, would I? It's already been vacated.
Oh, Jim.
It's already vacated. I told you that picture.
That's a prime spot.
It's a beautiful photo of Ozzy.
I mean,
but she looked up and she's like, what are you, gay? What the fuck is that?
It's a very pretty photo of Ozzy.
Yeah, that was what I was told. It's a beautiful photo.
She's right about that.
Yeah, but there was
what's going up in the place of these things?
Don't know yet.
Oh boy.
I'm gonna have to get a sconce, a chandelier.
A sconce?
Yes.
You're getting a sconce?
Yeah.
What happened?
Bro, if you're getting a... There's no fucking way I'm getting a sconce and not getting the Kiss poster.
Yeah.
I'm going, okay, I'll do sconce, chandelier, and Kiss poster, but it's like,
That's a tough sell for the living room when someone has to look at it all day.
Your problem is that you have been indulgent for so long.
Is it this one?
Yeah.
That is. That's
very handsome.
That's as homoerotic an Ozzy poster as I've ever seen.
It's 73. It's a great photo.
It's very sexy. And
it's
androgynous.
It's a weird photo to have.
Well, it's androgynous.
It's just a cool picture of Ozzy, and I saw it in this Morrison Hotel place in Soho.
Right, yeah.
Yeah,
but it's like, if it were in like Tiger Beat and girls put it on their walls, I'd be like, yeah, that doesn't seem out of place at all.
I understand.
Like, that is Ozzy's Tiger Beat photo.
I bought two other photos. That place is great. You been in there?
Yeah, I've been there.
Were you able to put the other two up?
They're still up. She wants them down, but I stood fast.
Good for you.
It's prior, two Richard Pryor pictures in front of the...
Oh, those are great.
In front of the American flag. From 1968, I'm like, there's no way those are coming down.
You've been indulgent whole life.
Yes.
So now I feel like you're going too far the other way. Like you're compromising too much because you know in your heart, you're an honest person to a fault. And you know in your heart that you've been so indulgent for so long that it's time for you to give up some of that stuff. But there's no reason that as you're giving stuff up, you can't be like, look, this is all a negotiation. I've given a lot here. I'm getting a sconce. For God's sakes, I'm getting a sconce. Okay?
Yeah. I know.
You can't...
A chandelier.
A little one, yeah. I put the...
chandelier here.
I said I don't want a giant chandelier. I'm like, it's not the 70s, and there's also a view. You don't put a giant chandelier when they have a view.
I mean, it's tacky. It's gonna be
54.
I know it's gonna be a little tacky.
Brian in Texas is. I hadn't considered this.
Hey, what's up, Brian?
Hey, man.
What's going on?
Hey, buddy.
Jim, you've got way more than one vote, brother. You've got Chip. You've got Uncle Polly. You don't just have the single vote, brother.
You're right.
It's true. Doug Bell.
Doug Bell would vote. Oh, he'd probably vote with her. He's such a white knight cuck. I don't know. I think she makes some good points. I think she makes some good points. Yeah. And if you ever need anyone to talk to,
yeah, hey, it's okay. You're right. You should share the space.
I mean,
I
still think, by the way, that the late night Doug Bell Zia podcast is like it's literally a masterpiece.
Oh, thank you.
A
yes.
masterpiece.
Yeah, it does capture that person well.
It's perfect.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah. No, Brian, you're right. You're right. There's so many different angles. Well, John in Virginia. What's up, John? John, you
Jim? John,
you there? Virginia, 540.
Hey,
buddy.
Hey, hello. I'm here. I'm calling in to defend Jim.
Ooh.
He's finally growing up. He's big boy Jimmy Norton. I mean, now he is also antiquing. He's talking about sconces. I don't agree with you all giving him such a hard time.
Thank you, John.
And
I actually put a little thing out that I bought antiquing with potpourri in it. And I was thrilled to do it.
Jim.
I know. I was very happy to do it.
You can't totally forget yourself, though.
No, I know, but that's me. Like, I just like the way it smelled, and it looks nice in this old Sanka coffee can.
It's a Sanka can?
Yes, it is.
He loves Sanka.
He loves Sanka.
Yeah, I'm obsessed with it. It's such a shit beverage.
Nick in California. What's up, Nick?
Oh, hey, good morning, guys.
Hey, buddy.
I'm hearing this just awful sound of Jim just losing his manhood and that.
Yeah, we need to get you to
losing.
You need to talk. We need to get you with the top G. Okay.
That's like saying I think the Yankees are not doing well in the playoffs. It's over, Johnny.
You're putting up the headstone. You're saying peace out. Yeah.
No, I just don't mind at this point in my life. Again, I've had it my way for so long, and it really is hard to share the space and all that shit. That's the hardest part of relationships. It's not cheating. It's not that. It's the fucking, what do I hang on my wall?
You're sharing your full life.
Yeah.
Like, it's not about you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't mind it.
Do you guys nice.
Share your AIDS with her, or what's the deal?
That was date one. She's like, thanks. I like you. I'm like, I hope so, because we're tied together.
Yeah, maybe a couple of those Hustlers U classes will get Jim on the right track.
Oh, I know.
Yeah.
Yes.
Jimmy on Staten Island. What's up? What's up, Jimmy?
Hey, what's up, Jim Sam?
Hey.
I have these Pepe Le Pew Warner Brothers prints and sells, right? Because I collected it because I had a little gray streak when I was young that everybody called me Pepe Le Pew.
Mm-hmm.
So I have them, and I have a media room in my basement, and I told my wife, when we first married, I wanted to put them up down there. She said, no fucking way. Here I am, 21 years later, still looking at them wrapped up on the wall, and recently, in June, right? I died twice, was in a coma for 9 days, so I tried pulling that card out before I hang him up on the wall. And guess what? No fucking way.
Wait.
Wow. How big are they?
They're not big at all. It's just that I'm not going to go downstairs and do laundry and look at the fucking skunk on the wall. I was like, really?
I have an idea.
I resized the whole house. I redid the fucking brick steps to the cobblestone plant at the wall. Everything she wanted. And she wanted to hang my Pepe Le Pew shit on the fucking wall. Guess what?
Pepe Le Pew,
no,
I just...
Yeah.
How many...
I died twice.
Hold on. So did I. I had two shows on Friday. How many cells are there?
There's like six of them. And they go in my basement.
Here's what you could do. Let me ask you. Could you do this? Could you compromise on the wall? If you could have three and then three under it, right? Can you do that trick that they do in restaurants where you know how they'll have a wall and they'll put like a fake curtain over the wall so it looks like there's depth, it looks like there's a window behind it? Maybe you could hang up... What?
Jimmy.
Yeah.
So naive. You're so naive. You're so fucking. I'm married 21 years. What if I'm 23? Really? No fucking way.
No, Jim, no, no. He almost died twice.
You hang them, and then you put these.
He died twice.
You put these fake curtains around them. And then when she wants to, she can actually close the curtains and not have to look at them. And it will just be these curtains, which is weird in the middle of a wall.
I mean,
but it's a trick people do. And in restaurants, they do it all the time. Yeah, it looks great.
She doesn't live in an Applebee's.
It doesn't.
No, but it's not, looks good.
It's not a neighborhood bar and grill. And I bet his wife would be annoyed that every morning he'd come down and look behind the curtain. In my Pepe Le Pew, I died twice.
Yeah, I think that's your solution, Jimmy. I think you should do it.
The curtain's on the wall.
21 years, they're wrapped up. Come on, man.
Jim, would you do that with your Kiss poster? Put a curtain on it?
I'll tell you why I would. Because mine's not in the basement, Jimmy. Mine's in the living room where there's windows on either side. But if I could, I would do that. Yes, I actually think that's a good idea. Because you put them on the outside of it, so it just looks like... I mean, what else are you going
to
do?
In your place, they'd have to be like leopard print curtains or something like
yes,
that.
Yes, it would. I would say yeah.
I love it.
All right, thanks, Jimmy.
Thank you, Jimmy.
Glad you didn't die.
Yeah, yeah. I'm glad you're back with us.
Yes.
Yeah. Oh, this is great. Chuck in Boston. What's up, Chuck?
Hey, Jimmy.
Yes, sir.
You're always complaining about Dallas Cowboys. Oh,
yeah.
Boy. Are you... did you ever think about joining a fantasy team where you pick certain players from different teams and make your own team? This way you don't have to... I mean, I think you're a bandwagon jumper when the Dallas Cowboys and Pittsburgh Steelers in the 70s.
Yes.
And there's people that picked either Dallas or Pittsburgh, and they jump the bandwagon, and they think they're obligated to keep that same fucking team. I was a Pittsburgh fan when that happened, but then I'm like, why am I doing this? The teams are different every fucking year. So that's why somebody created fantasy football, so you can pick players from all the teams and get your favorite players and then, you know, go with that instead of relying on Dallas. Oh, Dallas sucks this fucking year. Why are you a fan? Why are you a fucking fan?
That's a good question. I'll be honest. I don't watch football enough to care about fantasy football. Our boys did win over the Lions this weekend.
What I think you should do, concentrate on fantasy training.
That's everyone. And by the way, I am actually a bandwagon fan. You're right. I am. Like, when they're winning, I want to watch them, and when they don't, go fuck yourselves.
But
I
really enjoy the fact that, like, the way you're talking about your home life, I feel like you're one season away from being the guy who has to lie and go like, oh, I have sets tonight, and you're sneaking out of the house to hang out in your friend's garage and do a fantasy draft, but you can't tell your lady.
It's a tough sell, though, this giant Kiss poster along with the Kiss bus post. I mean, it's in the living room.
You love Kiss.
I know.
Your middle-aged man wears Kiss beanie when you go out of the house. You're so successful. You have a giant fan base, and you leave the house with a Kiss beanie on your head. It's crazy behavior. But you love Kiss.
I do.
The Knights in Satan's Service.
I love the Kiss.
Rocking out. It's Jim Norton and Sam Roberts. Welcome back. Are we buying a poster?
No.
Oh. Are you sure? Boom! Hit it, Troy.
Feels good, right?
Feels so good.
Yeah.
I can do my own fucking house.
Kiss was better. Without people. You're the one earning the money, dude.
It's gotta hurt Ace and Peter that their best song came without them.
That they really found their groove after they left.
At least they were there for the movie. Kiss meets the Phantom of the Park.
Yeah, it was a good movie. It's very underrated.
What you got in your hand?
A dick. And a picture of you and the other one.
Aw, Jim. You're so sweet.
Oops. Dee-dee, lick it up.
Get all the numbers in.
Mm-hmm.
What's that, the CVV security? Is that what it's called? Boom, boom. Troy's air drumming.
I appreciate Travis just letting this one ride.
Well,
why not?
You gotta wait until
Jim's
the
busy.
I apologize.
No, that's all right. Don't apologize. Take your time.
Deepest apologies to my friends.
Put the old expiration date in there.
Make sure that shipping address is correct.
Oh, yeah. Could be different from the billing address.
Yep.
Write that sumbitch off.
We made it to the solo. Okay.
Well, let's see if it goes through. We ain't bidding. Buy it now.
Well, we'll see.
Yep. Did it go through?
Well, I see up top.
What's it say?
Says this item is out of stock. Jim, somebody bought the Kiss poster.
Did they?
Yeah.
Who pays the bills, bitch?
Yeah, Jimmy!
You make my dinner and look at Gene while you do it.
Yeah! Way to hit the post!
Hey, I want some soup. Why don't you look at the God of Thunder and make me some soup?
This is the house that the Knights and Satan service helped build, bitch.
And by the way, keep talking. There's more work to be done.
You bet.
Fuck.
You bet.
You're dealing with your fucko.
You gotta be fucking kidding me.
Oh, please.
All those years. All the crummy gigs.
Yep.
All those weekends away from home.
All those crummy gigs.
All those awful co-hosts that you had to deal with.
Oh, yeah.
All the make a dime. Okay. All the make a dime. And for what?
That's right.
For what?
For what?
So I can what? Buy a chandelier?
So I can be bossed around in my own fucking house?
I don't think so.
Hold on 1 minute. Oh, come on.
Oh, let's go.
That's from goddamn Destroyer.
Let's leave our seats.
Jesus Christ, I want to leave my seat.
Don't leave your seat. You got to put in all the data correctly.
Yeah. That's right.
This is a good one, too.
We love Saturday
night. Boom, boom. Boom, boom, boom.
Oh, this is awesome.
This is awesome.
Yes, it is.
They made a song about the movie.
Yes. Yep. I love e-commerce.
Yeah, me too.
E-commerce
me too.
Rules.
Yep, it does. Get up. All right, let's see.
And when I get home, my wife's going to be like, all right, where are you going to put the Smoking Skull Championship now? And I'm going to say, wherever I want, bitch.
Nice.
Yeah.
She's hanging in the living room.
Yeah. It's going in the living room. Boom, boom. Boom, boom.
Oh, there's a German one, too, that's Attack of the Phantoms.
Hey, why pick?
Why not both?
Why pick
why
when you can have both?
How big
it's
is
your
it?
Apartment.
Oh, it's 33 by... It's regular poster size.
Get up!
Pussy.
Get down!
Deet, 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 deet. All right, guys, I apologize.
No one apologize. You're staking your claim as a man, dude.
That's
right. If you missed the first part of today's show,
biting a pillow. All right, hold on.
If you missed the first part of today's show, go back, use the app, get on demand. Because let me tell you something. We spent the morning talking to our friend Jim.
That's right, we did.
And our friend Jim just found himself.
That's right.
And when he gets home, he's in Dutch.
Feels good right now, though.
Oh, it feels great right now.
Yep. Go ahead, say something.
That's right. Travis is allowed to hang up his Tinkerbell statues.
Yeah.
You can hang up your Kiss posters.
That's right. We tell the ladies what to do.
Yeah. Hey, bitch, this is where my Tinkerbell goes. Every time I say that, I think of Tom Green talking to his parents. Remember, Dad, when you would say, where's my dinner, bitch? Made the statue and put it on their front lawn.
They were so mad.
They were furious. Then he airbrushed his car into the slut. Look, Dad, it's the slutmobile. I wanted to do something nice.
You had to drive it to work.
Well, you had to take the bus that day.
Yeah.
And then Tom Green drove to the bus stop in the slutmobile. He was furious.
Dee 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 dee.
Furious.
That was very funny.
But hey, the Tom Green Show, not the Green Tom Show, is what bought that house. So So you know what? What Tommy wants, Tommy gets.
That's right.
And what Jimmy wants, Jimmy gets.
Well, you know, within reason, but...
Boom, boom, boom. Boom, 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 boom.
I'd stay right now. Come on.
Oh, this is awesome.
I don't like being told what to do.
No. You're like Rage Against the Machine right now.
Yeah.
I won't do
I'm not going to do what you told me. Yeah. Fut.
You're 54 years old. You can't hang up a 6-foot kiss poster. I won't do what you told me.
That's right.
He's buying another one.
He should be. Yes, that's right.
No, I'm not.
Why let it go to waste? What did you work for? What did you, Jim, what is all the success for if not to enjoy it? Ooh.
Jesus Christ, Strutter, come
dun,
on.
Dun, dun. That's right. Because guess what?
What?
She'll only make you cry, but not this time. That's She'll right. say no to a kiss poster, and you'll say, "Where's my dinner, bitch?"
That's right. Yeah, I've made a good decision.
No, you haven't. You've made a great decision. Yes. She'll let you walk the street beside her.
Ow!
Oh, yeah.
Yep, there
Everybody
we go.
Everybody said she's looking good.
All right.
What do we do, Jim? What decision did we make?
What, are they only... The fucking Phantom is the only thing?
No. What do we get? What do we get for the home decor? You waited.
I believe that Kiss also did a concert in 1976 in Germany.
Is there any evidence of that?
There's a poster.
And where's that poster going to be?
Well, let's see. Hopefully it'll be on its way. You don't want a Kiss poster? You get two.
That's right.
Good for you.
Fine. We won't hang up one Kiss poster.
We'll hang up two.
We'll hang up two international Kiss posters.
Can you look up on eBay real quick then?
Maybe!
eBay?
Yeah.
The Kiss. Mm-hmm. Let me see.
1976?
Yep.
German.
Yep.
Got it.
If it comes up.
It shouldn't, because it's been purchased.
Well, let's hope so.
You're not 100% sure if you did it?
I'm not sure if it goes through.
Strutter!
Yeah. Oh, well. Look at that.
Is it the second one right here?
Nope, keep scrolling down. Maybe it doesn't have German in it.
Or maybe it's not coming up because it's been purchased.
I don't know. All right, well.
That's awesome, dude.
Yeah.
You're the fucking man, dude.
Ah, you know.
You're the coolest.
Yeah, thank you.
You have Kiss posters everywhere. And you should.
Yes, I do.
It's the Norton Palace.
I can't even. What the hell does this say?
Let me see.
My fucking eyes are all fucked up.
Let me read it for you. That says, "Thanks, James. Your order is confirmed."
There it goes. There, right, that right that doesn't exist anymore.
This one?
Yep.
Good for you. That's a cool one.
No, you're right. It says this listing has ended.
Sold!
Some sellers waking up to good news.
Sold for the cool price of $1,000.
Yep.
This is exactly what it's worth.
Yep.
That's right.
Tell me I can't have a poster? You get two.
$1,000 is too much for a poster? What about $1,000 a piece?
Yeah. Oh, I don't like that Kiss poster. Really? You're only going to be able to see it. You will not be able to look anywhere without seeing that poster.
That's right. Because it's humongous.
It's giant. Kit. You want to see the Empire State Building? Look at Kiss.
That's right.
Hey, I want to see the Freedom Tower. Cool. Enjoy Kiss.
You can see the Statue of Liberty from here. You can also see Gene and Paul
and Kiss.
Peter.
God, I love the view. And Kiss.
And Ace.
They're going to be right there.
That's right.
Every day.
Because you'll be able to look in the sky and see space, but you'll be able to look at the wall and see space Ace.
Yeah, I am. I'm going to be in a lot of trouble with this. Ooh, that was bad.
Feels good now, though.
Yeah, that's bad.
At least you have them. It's secured. You'll figure out the rest later, but you got the poster.
Well, the one I know I can hang up, I just will swap out one that's already hanging there.
Yeah. And go, what are we going to? waste all this money. We got to hang him.
Isn't that nice?
Cool. That is cool.
It's beautiful.
You think so?
Yeah. I think it's really cool.
That's a German.
It's an iconic photo.
It's the destroyer painting.
No,
but the fact that it's
yeah.
The fact that, and like the...
Oh, yeah, this is right up Mike's alley. He lived in Germany for years.
Yeah, and I like that the font is not the KISS font.
Right, it's
like
regular.
A varsity lettering font because they just made it in Germany, obviously. So it's just, it's authentic. I like it.
Yeah, it's an original. I like the yellow on it, too.
Yeah, looks cool.
This is cooler than a used shirt.
Yeah.
That's not the competition, dude.
Yeah, but if you had to pick one.
I can't. Mick Foley main event at one WrestleMania.
Try it.
I would take the poster over the smelly shirt.
Yeah. It doesn't smell at all.
But I'm just realizing what I did.
That's fine. Yeah. Well, the music was playing. The guys were cheering you on.
Yeah.
It was an exciting moment.
Yes, it was.
You can play it back for her. She'll be understand, like...
Wow.
They were saying, like, make my dinner, bitch, and stuff like that.
I was just kidding.
I was just joking. It was, you know, you could play her the Tom Green skit, maybe. He's just kidding around.
Yeah.
No, the guys are cool.
Do you know what I was doing? I was displaying bravado.
It was a false bravado, as it turns out.
Yeah.
Well, I'm anxious to see. Well, luckily, you know, it'll take a little while to ship, so you won't have to deal with it right away.
Yeah.
It's going to be a big package. 6 foot by 4 foot?
It's all folded up.
Oh, it's folded, though.
I can't tell.
It's not rolled, I guess.
Yeah.
John on Long Island. What's up, John?
Good morning, fellas.
Good morning.
Good evening.
Well, Jim, just admit it. Your future pretty much is going to be you're going to wind up selling your apartment, moving to Bestchester,
woo!
Being Sam's neighbor.
Nice.
And then you're going to live out a life that's going to be like Jim Belushi in Neighbors. Now, who's going to be who? You guys could argue that.
Thank you, John. That sounds great. Me, you, and Bob Kelly just tearing up Westchester. We go to Paul Verzi's house.
No, I don't want a home invasion.
None of us have experienced home invasion. I just listed three people you know that live in Westchester.
Not yet.
None of us have experienced a home invasion.
I'm going to have to give up a lot for this.
You got it.
You know what Jim is saying right now? I will never recover from this financially.
No, I mean giant mirror, vanity, desk.
It's worth it.
Oh, I can't wait to see how, I can't wait to see how this plays out, though. Can you?
I can't wait either.
It's going to be great.
How often are you in your bedroom?
Yeah, exactly.
Who cares?
That's not your bedroom anymore.
Yeah.
You got you got the wall in the living room.
No.
That's her bedroom. You're sleeping in her bedroom. Going
you know
forward.
What's in the living room?
A
fucking awesome Kiss Fest.
I tell you what, anywhere you look, you're going to know exactly what's in that living room. Gene is flying through the sky.
She's gonna hate it.
It's 6 feet.
Give up the bedroom.
It's so big.
6 foot by 4 foot.
Post. It's ceiling to floor.
It's larger than an average man.
It's way bigger than Jim.
It's literally, yeah.
It's giant. And then you're going to frame it, which
it's
is going
to
add
cost
like.
As much to frame.
It's going
to
cost a lot of money.
Oh, with museum glass? Forget
oh,
it.
Oh, yeah. You need a 6 foot by 4 foot piece of museum glass?
Yeah, it's going to.
Oh, flatulated because you're nervous about how it's going to go over.
Uh-huh. I know how it's going to go over.
How?
Poorly. Very poorly. It's going to go over very, very poorly.
It's fine.
It's going to go over great. I think it's going to maybe be gangbusters.
Fucked up.
Everyone that comes over is going to think it's awesome.
You fucked up. Oh, fuck.
I got excited with the guys. I fucked up.
Oh, the guys were encouraging me. We were joking around.
I'm going to have to give up a lot for this.
I fucked up on it.
I don't even know when I'll... What's that?
You're not going to regret it.
No, I don't even know when I'll be able to hang it, but at least I'll have it.
Yes.
At least you got it.
I had the Richard Pryor poster for probably 8 years before I hung it up. I forgot I had it.
That's what you're going to say, too. I don't even know where I'm going to hang it.
We'll figure it out later. Yeah.
The
yeah.
German poster is nice, but it's in English, and it's different.
Oh, that's cool. So big.
Yep.
It's big, but it's cool.
It's 6 feet tall.
You can lie down next to it, and it's still going to be
on top.
It could be a blanket on a single bed, yeah.
The German one is small, regular poster size. This is...
No, the other one is the size of a full-size bed sheet.
Yeah, 23 bigger. By 30.
Actually, a little bigger. 6 feet long? The sheet would be too long.
Great condition, though.
Yeah. Oof. Oh, boy.
I'll tell you what.
That'll give a little color to it.
I know one lady that's going to have a nice Christmas this year. What do you
have for the guy?
Oh, boy.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, I've learned it the hard way. You can't be running around buying nice watches for yourself, and then your lady's birthday comes up, and guess what? All things have to be equal.
Do you know what's funny? At least I don't spend money on watches. I don't spend money on clothes. I spent money on one suit recently I needed. That's it.
One? You get a lot of clothes at cost.
Yeah, I don't spend money on clothes.
Spend money on Kiss posters, though. That your lady doesn't want you hanging up.
Hey, who wants to talk to me?
Is that G Yogurt Liddy?
Liddy. Hey, Liddy.
Liddy in Portland.
Hey, guys. Jim, good job. That is awesome that you bought it.
Yeah.
But it's probably never going to go up.
Oh, that's why would you thing. Say that, Liddy?
I know. I'm so sorry. But that is funny. I was listening to you guys. Do wrap it up for Christmas. That would be funny, right? And then give it to her. And then that'll be something that you guys have together.
It's ours. And it's our Kiss poster.
It'll be ours.
No, with my luck, she would.
Oh, that's a fun story.
This is our New York Christmas present.
No, because she always gets the fucking packages. So I know she'll open it. I have to tell her I did it. But yeah, I want her to rip it open thinking it's something else.
Sam's house.
Tell the doorman to hold any tubes.
It's not going to come in a tube. It'll be folded.
It might come in a tube.
Yeah, yeah,
the big one.
Yeah.
The big one.
Yeah,
she opens the packages?
The big one will come or folded. Sam's or something like that.
You can send it to my house. I mean, I already
sent it, yeah. Oh, already, that would have been a good idea. I didn't think of it.
Yeah.
You can probably go in and change that. No, but can't. If no, you have a story
over.
With it, it'll be a cute, fun story.
Yeah, but if he plays the audio, she's going to go like, oh, I'll go on the app and I'll listen. And then she'll listen to the audio, and we keep yelling about, where's my dinner, bitch?
Yeah,
it was terrible.
I got caught up in the moment.
It wasn't flattering at all. It was, Jim kept saying things like, who makes the money, bitch?
I didn't mean that. Wait, let's redo that in case she hears it.
Yeah, cut that out.
You didn't mean that?
No, let's go back.
Okay.
I fade out of the Kiss music.
Yeah. Okay. Just like
you
put up.
You were hyped up. You had all your buddies around.
Yeah. I'm gonna redo it. We're gonna if I ever all have right. to replay this.
Thank you, Liddy. Yeah, we'll redo it right now.
I want to put this.
Okay, now like maybe fade out of Strutter, like get it up and then bring it down.
I bought the poster. You know why?
Why?
Because for us, she's gonna love it. I want her to be happy while she's cooking. I want her to look over there and see Gene.
That's a very nice gift for the person that you love.
That's right. And cook fast, bitch, because I'm hungry.
You did it again. You fucked up, dude. You got excited.
I'm hungry. The God of Thunder wants his food.
Well, now we've got ourselves a saga. I can't wait to see how this turns out.
I already know it's not going to go well.
No,
because I know I can do it.
She's going to open it and go, why did you order this?
But I don't want to live that way where I'm making this. You know what I mean? Like, I don't want to be a fucking dick.
That's okay.
The little one won't be a problem. No. I'm going to swap out my Kiss Black Velvet poster.
That's fine.
Black Velvet! God, I hate that fucking song. You like it? Nah. That stinks.
John... in Illinois. What's up, John?
Yeah. Jimmy, you may not want to buy that. She might be buying it for you for Christmas.
That's like saying, hey, I just got something in the mail. I hope it's a private jet. Not buying it for me for Christmas.
It might surprise you.
Probably not. Thank you, John.
Yeah, she's not going to be happy.
No?
Ooh.
Oh, I can't wait.
Ooh.
I can't wait. Yeah, go get it framed. Once it's framed,
it's
going to be humongous.
A part of me would love to just... I have to tell her I got it, though, because I don't want her to open it.
Tell her Troy convinced
she
you
open
to
your
do
mail?
It.
She'll open anything that comes up because she orders stuff on my eBay, on my Amazon. Mm-hmm. So a lot of times, it's just like...
Well, this is international, so just tell her not to open anything.
I can't lie. I should say I bought you a Christmas present.
Yeah.
What are you going to do? What are you going to do for
poster? She'll see poster.
This is going to come folded.
No, but the other one will.
She's going to go like, I know what this is, you idiot.
I'll tell her. Yeah, I can't.
What are you going to do at Christmas time though? When you start like, are you going to order her like presents? Like she's got to stop opening the packages, otherwise this surprise will be spurled.
Yeah, it's true.
This is going to go over like a ton of bricks.
Yep, like a lead balloon. He's right. I already.
It's going to be a tough sell.
It's going to be an impossible sell.
When I bought that Mick Foley shirt, I had to sell many items to make up for, like, just so you know, it's not coming out of the family budget. I had to sell many, many great and cherished
items. I'm
going
to have to give up the office, the entire decor of the office, and the bedroom. for this.
Yeah. It's fair.
When you wake up, when she's cooking, she's going to see Gene and Paul. But when you wake up in the morning, you're going to see cheetah print.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
It'll be worth it.
You think so?
I think so. Because that's an awesome poster.
It's a Gene's so big on it.
There's two Genes.
I think you guys hate it, but I do understand.
No, I actually, the poster's cool, but the scenario is the best. Yeah. I'm in love with the scenario. I don't care what the poster looks like, if I'm being 100% honest. I just like the scenario. It is a cool poster for a collector, though. I like wrestling stuff. There's, you know, I get it.
It's going to be the whole wall. Mm-hmm.
Well, yeah, plus you got to understand, like, when you frame something, you're adding
a lot.
2 to 3 inches on each side. So you're talking about more like 6.5 feet.
Yep.
Like 6'6".
Yeah.
Which is like...
It's a lot of wall.
A giant of a man.
Massive. A lot of wall.
I don't know anybody who's 6'6".
I don't either.
It's so big.
Yeah, it's big. I do, Ralph Sutton.
It's a
big galoot. 6'6".
Can you imagine a Ralph Sutton sized poster?
Literally, I bought Ralph Sutton and I'm putting it on my fucking wall. I should just hire Ralph to stand in my apartment.
Yeah. Your lady's going to be like, this is taking up so much space, this Ralph Sutton.
Do you know how hard this is going to be to move? Have to move?
Yeah.
And you will. You're going to have to move to the Best Jester.
I mean, they can move it, but.
You're going to be watching them. Yeah. Be careful with that.
Careful.
6 feet of museum glass.
Is it even going to fit in the elevator?
Yeah, 6 feet? Jeez, anybody, who do you, of course.
Of course.
What is this, a building for ants?
Sorry, I literally, because I thought for a second about it.
Well, you're stressed out.
Yes, I'm very, you can't tease me right now. I don't.
Jim's in a lot of trouble.
I answer
he's
questions.
He's not in trouble, he's fine.
I'm answering questions like Biden. How tall do you think it is?
Dr. Norton? No, Jim's in big trouble.
Does Dr. Norton want you to buy the post?
Do you think I fucked up?
I think you're in big trouble. I don't think you fucked up in the long term, but... Yeah, I think you're in big trouble, and I think...
It's not like it's hanging up, so we bought it. Big fucking deal.
Yeah, you own it. Who cares? Yeah.
There won't be any problem with me buying it. That's not the problem. I may have to wait to put it up.
Then you wait. It's a waiting game.
Look, I think you gave
up... there's nowhere to store it.
I think you just gave up a lot.
Yeah, everything.
Yeah. Yeah, you gave up a lot. Maybe it's worth it, though. I don't know. It's going to be awesome when you have people over and there's that giant Kiss poster. That's going to be badass.
Yeah, but
you're not going to like have to.
There'll be like a little table in front of it, I'm sure. Like, yeah. It won't be able to just be a giant, you know, there'll have to be something in front of it.
You may not have.
What?
You don't want to block it.
I have to block a little bit.
I mean, it's so big.
It's so beautiful, though. It's so magnificent.
Yeah. It is magnificent.
Yeah.
It's incredible.
Yeah. At least I'll have it. If I don't hang it, I don't hang it.
You'll hang it.
I know. Of course I'm going to hang it.
It's going right to the framer when you get it.
No, I will wait a little while. I'm trying to think of how I can sneak this in.
You got to wait for a good time to be like, I'm going to put that up.
Maybe you wait and hang it at Christmas and you give her a really nice Christmas gift.
Ooh, that's a good idea.
Probably...
Do you know how great that would be?
That's the move I would make. Give her a really nice romantic Christmas gift.
Yep.
And then hang it.
She's going to have to look at it every day.
Every day.
Every minute.
Every time she walks into the living room.
Every time she's in the kitchen. Every time she's watching TV.
She's going to long for the days when you guys didn't have access to the full apartment.
She's going
to
look, like, she takes a bath and she'll watch TV and she's just going to see Kiss.
Yeah.
Looming, just a Batman looming over her.
She's like, why is that Batman?
Please don't buy it. I got, like, to that point.
She said that?
Please don't buy it.
You just bought it.
I bought it. Tell me what to do.
You just bought it just now. I saw you. You got excited because the guys were around.
Yeah, this would be funny if we filmed it, but...
No. Can I tell you something?
What?
That would have been such a good video.
You frantically buying the poster?
All of us, like, jumping around, like, singing and going, yeah, yeah. It was a great visual for us.
You think there's going to be some apologizing today?
It's not even the best poster. It's just...
It's cool.
It's cool, though.
It doesn't have to be the best.
Are you going to tell her today? Or are you going to wait?
We'll see.
You don't have to tell her to...
No, I do because it's going to come in the... And she always knows when fucking stuff comes.
You have to tell her this week, for sure.
I don't want her opening it and ripping it by mistake.
Right.
Like her cutting it open.
Just tell her, don't open any international packages.
She's going to be like this. Jim, you haven't brought up the poster recently. You're like, because I bought it.
No, and I don't want to say don't open anything with like... Because
that's dishonest.
And also, she'll think it's for her. That, by the way, that is my greatest joy. when a package comes and I say something and she goes, did you buy me a present? She thinks I bought her a present. And I'm like, no. And she's like, you bought me a present. And she literally thinks I bought her something. And then just the disappointment when she opens it.
Yeah, it's like six cans of super tape.
Yeah, or it's those little black or clear dots that go on the back of a poster to protect the wall.
Oh, my God.
I fucking love it when she thinks she's getting a gift. And you want a gift? Yeah, I got two balls worth. 2 balls worth of present for you.
Yeah, it's going to be an all designer Christmas. Mm. I'm thinking.
I gotta work, man. I gotta back on the road.
Yeah,
I got a bunch of gigs I'm booking.
I hope Levity Live is full.
Levity
Live. Get to Levity Live. We got a big Christmas to pay for. Levity Live, New Year's Eve, the 30th and the 31st.
Yeah.
We gotta pack that place because Jim's got, I mean, a couple of bags, not one bag. It's gonna be a couple of bags, maybe a clutch. Yeah. Jewelry. Gotta be jewelry.
Jewelry.
Gotta be jewelry. And it's got to be like that's the problem. Like, I've seen Travis get stuck buying Tiffany's jewelry. And it's like, your money could go further, but it's Tiffany. I've had to do it, too.
That blue box.
The blue box. There have been times where it's been a while since my wife got a blue box.
Yep.
You need to throw in the blue box every now and then just to be like, I'm still thinking about you. I'm still in the game.
You think it's going to be expensive Christmas?
It's going to be real expensive Christmas.
Yeah. I could always replace the signed Clockwork Orange poster with this Kiss concert.
Yeah. You're going to have some shoes with red bottoms. That's what you're going to need, some size 11 red bottoms.
As long as I receive a nice red bottom.
Yeah.
Wait, do you think I could trade the Clockwork Orange for the smaller? I like that poster, but I could take the Clockwork Orange down.
For the smaller one?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's a cool trade.
Yeah.
It's going to be an expensive Christmas, dude.
The big one is the problem.
Let me tell you something. What you just spent on those posters, chump change compared to what you're going to have to spend at Christmas.
Fine. Yep. It's all part of the game.
I could put it in the hallway.
The big one?
This is going to be Jim at Christmas. I got you a Louis Vuitton.
No, you don't want to put it in the hallway because it's so big. You won't have a good viewing angle of it because it's huge.
You got to see it from far away.
Yeah.
How could
you
not?
You have to just bask in the majesticness.
You bought a Kiss.
Of a 4 foot by 6 foot.
Do you understand what you just... Do you understand you just bought a Kiss billboard for your house?
Yes, I did. Yes,
there's going to be a Kiss billboard in your living room.
It isn't a real... I really do. I've seen it framed in a picture, and I actually really love it.
You know you're going to need a Christmas tree in your apartment.
I've already been talked to.
There's going to need to be
Christmas shit has already been spent.
And not like a nice Christmas tree, like probably a tacky, like...
No, fake one.
Yeah.
Fake.
But do you think like a green one, or do you think like a foil, like...
Probably green, traditional. Okay.
But with decorations.
Christmas is fun, though.
I don't mind that. Yeah. I don't mind Christmas.
But you know what's gonna hurt? Filling up the bottom of it.
Oh, there's going to be a lot of different colored designer boxes.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah. I'm thinking definitely a Louis Vuitton bag.
Yeah, a burnt orange bag.
Oh, yeah. We got a Louis Vuitton bag, some Louboutin shoes.
Fuck Louboutin. She doesn't like Louboutin.
Woo!
It's good Woo! For you.
Yeah, and you want to hear the best? She went to Bergdorf. We're looking for something in particular, and she's like, I don't like Bergdorf. And I was like, do you know how fucking happy that makes me? She loves Macy's.
Oh, beautiful. Beautiful. Macy's. Oh,
Macy's
then we.
Gift card.
Yeah. I got you a Macy's gift card. You could get, do you understand? $2,500 Macy's gift card. At this point, you could buy the company. Do you know what you could get at Macy's for $2,500?
Everything.
Everything.
Yeah.
That's great. Okay, all right.
I got to do more gigs. Back on the road. That's it.
And see, because it's not the cost.
10 shows at Levity Live.
It's not the cost of the posters. It's what the posters will cost you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
New furniture.
New furniture. Yeah, that's where it'll hurt.
You bet.
It's going to be great.
He's going to hurt a lot.
It's going to be great. It's going to be worth it. It's just going to be such a great, but you're going to, now that you're like putting your, this is like us putting our flag on the moon. Or the set that they said was the moon. Yeah, allegedly.
Putting our flag in that warehouse.
Yeah. This is like that. You're putting your flag down, but now she's going to get to put her flag down, too.
Yeah.
And which means she's going to have to go just, like, this is going hard. 6 foot by 4 feet in the living room, Gene Simmons, that's going hard.
Oh, yeah.
She's going to go just as hard.
She's going to make you pay for it.
Oh, yeah.
It's never going up. She's going to hate it. Like, it's just too
big.
Well,
it's got to go up.
It has to.
It has to go up.
You can't take no for an answer.
I feel like it might be a good idea for Jim to settle up before she sees exactly how big it is.
Ooh. Well, yeah, you got to settle up while
she already knows. I measured the wall the other day.
Yeah, but when you see it,
you got to settle up while it's at the framer. Right, so that once that it comes back from the framer, yeah, when it's framed, when you just see the sheer amount of glass,
then I think the price will increase.
It's like she's going to be like, "Well, where are we going to hang it?" And you're like, "We could literally just lean it against the wall. It's floor to ceiling."
You could do that.
You could lean it against the
wall. That is an absolute option. You get a thick frame,
lean it against the wall.
Lean it against the wall. That's not like
no.
Tons of people do that with gigantic pieces
of
art.
It's floor
to
ceiling.
That.
It doesn't, yeah. There's no reason you don't have to hang it.
You could do that.
And that way it would be a little.
You could anchor it to the wall.
Yep.
Like, so there's no chance.
Like you do with furniture.
Yeah.
Put a little string on the back.
No, I can't anchor it because if it's going to be on an angle, you mean?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah, no.
You got to hang it, Brendan. Hang it.
You think so?
Yeah.
You have to?
Have to.
Gotcha. You'd have to get men to come over and hang it for you.
Yeah, there'll be a lot of men there to deliver it. It's going to take a couple guys to get it in there.
Yeah,
there's no way.
Home
yeah,
on the subway.
No.
No, no, no.
Although that'd be really cool.
My framing place is literally less than a block from my house.
Oh, good.
Well, they're going to have to. I mean, you can't carry that yourself.
No, me and one of them will have to figure out how to do it.
You're going to have to put like the blankets around it.
Yep. Moving blankets.
Moving blankets. Yeah. It's 6 feet of glass.
I've had one carried. Already guy helped me carry it.
How big?
The long one I have, the bus poster.
Oh, okay. All
I
right.
Couldn't
all
carry
right.
that alone. Yeah, one guy will carry it. It's heavy, but I mean, it's manageable.
4 feet by 6 feet, I feel like it's a four-person job.
Yeah.
4 feet by 6. Oh, yeah, because 4 feet to get your arm around like
yeah,
that.
Yeah, I think you're just carrying it flat, two people on each.
Yeah, but there's got to be a way to.
Maybe they could dolly it. Put it on a dolly.
Yeah.
There you go.
Yeah.
Dolly that little
dolly
joker.
Dolly that joker.
Get that joker on a dolly.
Yeah, and then you hang
that's
it up.
All. You're just telling your lady.
You know how heavy that is?
Don't worry about it. I'm just getting a Kiss poster that's so big it has to be dollied into the apartment.
What do I do?
That's a tough stuff. What did you do, dude?
Oh.
You fucked up.
Yeah. Jim's going to be like when those texts got printed out. I have a problem.
I have a problem. I love Kiss.
I need help.
Yeah. Because the thing is, there's only one place in the house it can go.
Then that's where it goes.
That's where it has to go. That's the only place it can go.
Right now, my Woody Allen poster's hanging up. It's actually...
The Woody Allen poster might have to go.
Oh, it's just going to go to the other side.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's fine.
I can't wait to ask her what she thinks. I'm going to let it give it a little time. I don't want to, like... Well, I don't want to... While the wound is still fresh, I'm going to let you guys work it out. But eventually, I'll ask her.
I hope it's not too heavy for the wall and Jim is woken up one morning. Oh.
Wouldn't that be great? Just broken drywall and glass all over the ground. I told you this was a bad idea. You're an idiot. Why would you buy this poster? I know, you said. I know.
A huge hole
the guy's got me excited. The guy's got me excited. Troy was singing along. They're playing Lick It Up.
Lick It Up was
They're playing
on.
Lick It Up. What did she expect? Lick It Up was on. I'm... Fucked up.
Yeah, it probably won't fall because it's big, but it's like if you anchor it to the wall with two of those hanging things, they can hold like 50 pounds each or more. I don't think it's going to be more than 100 pounds. The frame might be very fucking heavy, though.
No, because museum glass is very
what's designed
light.
Designed to be hung.
Yeah.
Museum
yeah, it
glass.
Won't be that heavy.
Wish I was. I don't mean my dick either.
Yeah, no, no. You're not designed to be hung because you got no chin. The road just slips right off.
Yeah. Broke my nose twice.
That's awesome. That rules. You made a good choice.
Yeah, I think so.
I'm nauseous.
You are?
I just did. Just thinking about it.
Do you have anxiety?
Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. You have to explain this one.
Because the problem is...
She already told you she didn't want it.
Vehemently.
She was like, why would you buy that poster after the conversation we had? I don't know. The guy's got me excited.
Christ got me. Christ.
And then someone called up. He said I wasn't being like the old Jim. Someone from Texas called. He said I
got peer pressure.
He
into
said
it.
The guy from Texas said I was listening
I'm
to Sam.
I'm literally
going to
blame you guys the way Billy Bibbit blamed McMurphy when fucking Nurse Ratched walked in. Who made you? Sam Travis.
They were fist pumping and everything.
The guys got me going. They had the music. Fucking Detroit Rock City made me buy the extra one.
I was so excited. I was even like on my phone while the show was on. I said, I'm sorry. They said, no, just keep doing that.
Encourage me.
Encouraged my behavior.
Can't hear you.
It was literally like the bathroom break. Like, we went to the bathroom, all of a sudden he walks into the studio, he's like, I'm buying it. It was literally just...
Well, he knew. He knew it was the right decision to make. It was an exciting bathroom break. I saw Dropkick Murphys playing two doors down.
What are they doing?
They have, I guess, a new, like, acoustic album. Yeah. So they were doing stuff for Outlaw Country, but they were performing. It's like 9 o'clock in the morning to hear the singer from Dropkick Murphys still sound like a million bucks.
Is he belting it out?
Yeah, it sounded great. I mean, it's acoustic, so they're not like shouting, but he sounded amazing. I had to step in and experience a little bit of it. I was thinking about getting a 6-foot by 4-foot Dropkick Murphys poster for my place, but my wife would be pissed.
I wouldn't even get this one signed. Like, this is one you just want like it is.
Yeah, I think that's fine. Yeah. Plus,
really? Well, you don't get that signed.
It'd be tough to get signed because it's so big.
But what happens if you get the picture with all four that you've been wanting?
That has to get signed. That's different.
But then you could bring this and then all four of them signed?
Nah.
Is this going to be in the same room as your giant Black Sabbath photo?
What?
This poster? Is that the same?
No, that's the hallway.
That's the hallway.
This is the living room.
Do you have any, you know you're going to have to put pictures of you and your lady up.
It's fine.
The two of you doing couple things, antiquing.
Great. Whatever you want to hang a picture of. If this goes up, whatever you want to hang pictures of.
She's literally, it's not, it. She's going to have jurisdiction of everything. You'll still have maybe like some in the hallway. You have a little bit of space in the hallway, and then you'll have this poster, and everything else is going to be hers.
Yeah, no, John. John Long Island is a terrible idea.
Okay. You missed it. What's up, John?
Morning again, fellas.
Hey, buddy.
Would a compromise be, Jim, if you took the poster to a professional copier, had it copied and reduced, and then something...
No. It's got to be the original. It's got to be the original.
Yeah.
Just suggestion.
No, John, that's not going to work. Thank you, buddy. You got to... It's the original is the thing.
Yeah.
When I get stuff to the house, it's hours. It's never days. It's hours, maybe 2 hours sometimes, that I open it up, I take it out, it ends up in the basement on the stairs. Like, I open the door, and it's just my wife has put whatever I've got on the stairs. Bring it downstairs. I don't want to see it.
Yep.
Yes, I'm. You got it.
Yep. I just got a text from the guy. They're coming to fix my shade now, so...
Good. Well, maybe you wait until the shade's fixed, and so things are happy in the Norton house, and then go, oh, yeah, I get more good news. I remember that poster you wanted?
This is why I'm really nervous. I'm never nervous about shit like this.
Yeah, no,
never. I've never had to consider it.
Okay.
Because I'm not mad about buying it. Like, I bought it, like, whatever. If I ever wanted to, I could resell it. Even if I lost a few $100, I could still sell it for $700.
I mean, whatever. You got the $1,000.
But I don't like to waste money either. I mean,
of course.
I don't
it's a lot of money, but it's like, no, I get it. But, like, I've made foolish purchases.
If I had to...
I paid $1,800 for Mick Foley's shirt on a... Because...
If I had to resell this, I could get $700 for it. Like, so I would lose a couple $100.
Yeah.
It's not a money thing.
Right.
But once it's framed... It's done.
There's nothing else.
Because everything else goes in my closet. This?
It's way too big.
What's the average poster size?
I mean...
24 by 36.
How many inches is this? Okay, this is 48
24,
by 6... No.
6 feet
72.
Is 72. Whew. 36. 72. It's twice as big. It's twice as big as a normal...
48 by 72.
Yeah. It's twice as big as a normal poster. Huge.
That's fine, though.
It's twice as big on both sides.
Take her out to a nice dinner. Break her the news.
Oh.
Maybe stop by Macy's.
What are we going to eat? Chanel? You want to eat out of a purse?
Stop by Macy's.
I'm going to tell you something. It's again. It's going to be a diamond encrusted Christmas.
I fucked up.
You're going to need to get some diamonds for Christmas.
Oh, yeah. Real diamonds.
Hey, I hate Steven Singer. Yeah. You're gonna need diamonds for Christmas, dude.
Yeah, he's gonna have to design something real nice.
Yeah, I mean, and not some things that are really nice.
Yeah.
Earrings, necklace, yeah. Bracelet,
matching set. Maybe.
Ooh, a diamond bracelet with all the diamonds all over.
From I Hate Steven Singer.
That's a lot. Yeah, you're gonna have to plug the shit out of it, because otherwise, that's it for the cash. It's a wrap.
Someone just texted me, my friend,
mm-hmm.
and she said, "Here's my lady advice: get the Kiss poster, but." To offset the Kiss poster, pick a picture of you and your girlfriend and get it printed and framed and display it in a place of prominence.
Now, okay.
There's nowhere in that apartment that could make up for this, unless I put giant pictures of her on all four windows.
Yeah. I mean, you could put...
Yeah, what about like the table in the living room?
What if? I bought the poster. I fucked up. Whatever.
Fucked up.
You bring it to the framer, right?
I fucked up.
You didn't fuck up. It was a decision.
But here's the surprise. Here's the surprise that you don't tell her.
I made a mistake. It's fucking so weird having to think this way. I've never in my life had to think this way. Until I was a kid.
Right.
When I was a fucking kid.
Right.
My buddy James would hang Kiss posters on the ceiling. And I, because this was whole wall and ceiling were covered in Kiss posters. I was so jealous because my mother said, no ceiling. You cannot put posters on your ceiling.
I wasn't allowed to put posters up with tape, only blue tack.
Oh, remember that?
Yeah, blue tack only.
Would it work?
Yeah. But then the blue tack would leave like residue behind anyway.
Well, yeah, it had acid in it.
Yeah.
Fuck yeah.
Here's what you do.
Maybe anchor it to the ceiling.
Here's what you hang it from the ceiling so it's dangling.
So it starts swinging.
Yeah. Here's what you do.
That's funny.
This is brilliant. This would be my move. You give it to the framer.
And no, because I bought it. I want it.
Okay, I thought just as a gift. You've done a lot of good work for me.
Why would I do that?
But when you drop it off at the framer, you also get like really great photos of the two of you. And you give them to the framer as well.
Yeah.
So when you get your stuff back from the framer, but you don't tell her about the nice, sweet family photos. So you're like, oh, this poster's back, and I thought it might be nice to have these as well.
Do you know how hard sell that's going to be when I walk back in the house with four cardboard covered things?
What's on a dollar?
Three regular size and one that is bigger than she and I. Oh my God, is that big?
Oh.
Massive.
That's a
massive poster.
It's so big.
I fucked up.
But you got to frame it. Yeah, dude. A lot of jewelry, a lot of real estate in the bedroom.
I don't even know if I'll like it.
Nah, you'll love it. Look,
what's not to love?
How cool it is. You can get rid of
it. Are you having buyer's remorse?
Not for the money, though, because, again, I could always resell it. Like, I know that. Like, I could sell it.
No. But for what it's actually going to cost you. See that dollar sign up there? That's nothing compared to what it's going to. Yeah, that's nothing. That's a pittance. Compared to what it's actually going to cost you.
She's going to hate it.
Just the giant Batman looming over. Like, it
that's
cool.
What I want, this fucking Batman looking at me.
You know how you know she's going to hate it?
She's indicated that multiple occasions.
Sherry,
I hate it.
Sherry told
please.
You.
And then it got to a point where it wasn't even arguing. It was, please don't buy that. You know what?
Then you bought it.
I overrode her request.
Yes, you did.
I've heard your request. The answer is no.
Unfortunately, your request has been denied by the board.
Yeah, and I'm sorry to talk about this the whole show. I apologize.
I think people are on the hook for
I've never in my life had to deal with this, with compromising like what I wanted to put on the wall. Never.
The Jim poster saga part one, and now we're in part two, is great. There is no apologies to be had. Intern Mike, you having a good time today?
I'm loving it.
You're loving it, aren't you?
I'm loving every moment.
Because we've all been on...
He's talking thin air.
I said I'm loving every moment of it.
Thank you.
Yeah. We've all been on all sides of this equation. It's just fun that you're on this side of the equation for the first time.
Yep.
Like, we've all been in the position where we have our space, we can get whatever we want,
like,
we're doing our
thing.
This
is so old for everybody.
But also, yeah.
That's why I enjoy this.
Right. We all had to deal with this at some point.
Yeah.
Most of us, late 20s, early 30s, whatever, where it's like, okay, we gotta settle down and share space and justify things. We have to justify our purchases and decorations.
What does it look like when you get a giant poster to lean on the wall? Can we see what that looks like?
Well, it's not like a very steep angle, so it looks it still looks good, especially if the frame is nice. Like they do that shit in with like nice stuff in those decoration stores, like Pure whatever imports, whatever
Pure One Imports. Dump.
Yeah, it is, right?
Fucking stinks. Pure One Imports. You fucking Westchester trash.
It is garbage.
Yeah, that fancy place, you know, Pure One Imports.
I get all my... What's that fancy clothing? Kohl's.
Yeah, it kind of looks cool.
Yeah, it looks fine. It looks totally good. I think leaning it against the wall is going to be the move.
No, because then it's going to be near the TV and the whole thing. And it will have to cover over the vent, which might be okay.
But
because
it's going to be the whole wall regardless.
Oh, I can't. Yeah, cause it's just...
It's the whole wall. Well, you have 8-foot ceilings?
I don't know.
It's going to be real tall. Don't forget. At least if you lean it, you can skirt a couple inches off, right? Because it doesn't... Because it's slanted.
Now you got to hang it.
No, there's nowhere to put it.
So you better hang it?
Yeah.
Yeah, there is nowhere to hang... There's nowhere to lean it.
It won't look right.
No, I mean, I would...
She's going to see it every time... Like, that's the living room. That's where everything happens.
No escape.
No escape.
Where are you going, Travis?
I'm measuring.
Are you measuring?
Exactly how big it is.
Oh, great. He's done that before.
Exactly.
Is your phone confused because this is the first time it's ever gone over 2 inches?
Yeah, yeah. It's, yeah. It's like... Oh, are you doing like the... oh, that's the... Are you still going?
6 feet is right here.
He's still, yep.
It's up to the door hinge.
Where's 4 feet? Wow, that's a big...
That's big. That's big.
Go across.
Yeah, go from the hinge to the... Maybe to the left.
Yeah, oh, he's using
he's
the iPhone.
He's still going?
No, 4 feet is the door. Yeah. No, it's not.
He's still... Wait.
What are you doing? No, wait.
Right here.
Oh my God. Oh my God. I think I was picturing like 2.5 feet by 6 feet. That is so fucking wide, dude.
What did I do?
You fucked up, dude. I guess you, that's right, because 6 feet sounds so big and 4 feet, but it's still.
It's almost 6 by 6. It's a massive. How big is that window?
It's bigger than that window, I bet.
No, it's not bigger than that window.
4 feet is 2/3 as big as 6 feet. I forgot.
Yeah, I didn't.
Okay.
That window is...
Oh, my God.
It's probably about the size of that window.
I think it's bigger than that window. It's definitely bigger than that window. That window is not 6 feet.
This
if I laid it...
5 feet.
Oh, fuck.
It's a foot bigger than that fucking window. I bought a Kiss poster bigger than that window.
And how...
3...
It's 5x3.
It's
5x3. It's 5x3.
You have another foot.
It's wider than that window. Oh, I wish you could see Jim's face right now. Oh, Jim fucked up.
I don't know what I did.
It's so wide. It's so wide. We were talking about how tall it is, and I forgot how wide 4 feet is. It's incredibly wide.
Yes, it is.
Look how big this window is.
It's a big fucking window.
You can have a linebacker in your room.
It's a giant.
It's a linebacker.
I've made an error. Nah. Troy?
I think you're fine. At least you have it. Figure out the negotiations later. You got the poster.
Ralph, I'm like, am I going to like it? Like, I don't
Ralph
know.
Sutton,
yeah, you're going to love it. It's
Ralph
so
Sutton
cool.
Is less than 4 feet wide. He's 6'6", sure, but he's less than 4 feet.
His head, maybe.
Maybe. I just remembered, too, with the frame.
Look how cool it looks.
We added added 3 inches on each size for
but it
the
won't
height.
Be a very wide frame. It would, there'll be some, but it'll be a pretty... Oh, you know what? It has to be a wide frame because it's so heavy.
Yeah, of course it does.
To support the glass.
At least two inches, the frame.
Oh, yeah, on each side.
So, at least 2 inches. So you're talking about 6'4" and 4'4".
I hope I can fit it. Yeah, I can.
You can.
4'4" Yeah, you're gonna have to. Yeah, just tip it. Yeah.
But I have a thing in front of that now, like a nice little display. I don't want it to block the poster.
No way.
Yeah, move it. It's gonna have to.
No way.
Move it somewhere else.
It's a whole goddamn wall. It's
you want to block it? Why would you block it?
It's almost 4.5 feet wide.
You might have to block a little bit.
You
just
can't.
To...
You can't block
yeah,
it.
Why?
Yeah. I don't know anybody that's 6'4" 4'4" wide. That's so much space.
You don't put a table in front of the Mona Lisa.
No, exactly.
That's because the Mona Lisa is not 6'4".
Actually, yeah, it's quite small.
Much smaller.
Yeah.
It's like a standard-sized painting.
This
is like 3 times the size of the Mona Lisa. If you had 3 Mona Lisas up and down and then 3 Mona Lisas across, you would block it with a table or something. Because the museum would be like this. There's no. It just takes up too much space. Look how big that window is.
Sam, stand in front of the window so I can tweet out a photo showing people how this isn't even that big.
All right, there we go.
There. It's huge.
Okay, I'm trying to get a...
What are you working on?
Just a picture of the area. I got a picture of the... No, don't tweet it out like that.
No, because he hasn't told his lady yet.
You can't tweet that.
Oh.
It's private.
This is just for me.
It's private right now.
I just have
right
a
now.
Photo of Sam for me.
I have a picture of
when
the...
Jim maybe tomorrow, maybe when Jim tells his lady...
There's the
then
wall.
We can,
good idea.
That's the wall with the Woody... The Woody poster is awesome. It's a signed Woody Allen poster. It has to go to the other wall now.
You can't tell, though, how big that is there.
Can't hear you.
It's big.
It's just a standard... You what? You can tell how
well
big
just
what,
for that photo. You can't see.
Oh
how,
yeah,
like
yeah.
Jim should be.
But isn't that
by
a great poster though?
It's yeah,
fucking
awesome.
Take
yeah,
the money and run. Signed from 60
big
whatever.
Deal. It's not 6'4".
You just have to find that another place for it.
That's all
on the other wall. So I've already yeah, sent to her the Woody. I'm like, imagine Woody right there and Kiss. I've tried selling it.
Do you understand that?
I wouldn't have worked on anybody but me.
After this,
I could have sold that to Jim Norton that way.
After this, every single design decision, no matter how minute it is,
I know,
will have to be approved.
It's everything,
and will probably be denied.
I know what the trade-off will be.
What?
A dog.
Oh, that's the move.
That's fair.
That's the move. That's